Nick had been dug out and tossed into a pit with other dead bodies when he had been unconscious. He woke and found himself sandwiched between the arms and legs of others, and he heard German voices, and he did not move. Confused and trying to remember, pain in his head and neck, and it took some time, but it slowly came back to him. Waiting at his post and waiting for the big explosion and falling to his knees and then the blast above him. And then as he dug and pushed at the earth crumbling around him, the grand explosion, and it all moved and it all shook and the clay and stone around him flew away and hung in the air and then came crashing back down and all went black. His thoughts foggy, but he tried to stay with them until he put enough of it back together. Eventually, he had slid open his eyes and saw the soldier standing at the edge of the pit smoking cigarettes. And every few minutes, other men in uniform would appear at the edge of the pit with a big wheelbarrow stacked with the dead. The bodies wore different flags on their sleeves, but that mattered no more, as the pit was a place of equality. Nick watched as more bodies were dumped, and they slid down and tumbled awkwardly onto the others. He couldn't move or they would kill him. And he knew he was bleeding from more than one place, but his choice was to move and be shot or stay still and pray that he didn't bleed dry before he could try and climb out and into the cover of night. He prayed. He promised God and Jesus and Mary and whoever else would listen that if someone would please save him, he would give it all back. And I will pray every morning and every night, and I will give everything I have away, and I will feed the poor and read to the sick, and please let me out of this hole, and please stop this bleeding. And if you help me climb out of this pit, please, dear God, let my legs work, and I promise I will give it all back. He prayed and promised and prayed and promised for 2 days, as there seemed to be no rush by the men surrounding the pit. He tried not to sleep, but he dozed in and out, and there was nothing in his dreams that didn't involve the wrath of man. And as soon as he woke, he began to pray and promise once again, as if it were synchronized with his cautious breathing. The Germans kept smoking and kept dumping bodies, and then finally, after 2 days and 2 nights of playing dead, after ignoring the vermin that crawled across his face, after promising God and the saints a lifetime of service and gratitude, he heard the German word for fire and he had no choice. The sun was dropping toward the horizon and the sky bled from pink in the west to lavender in the east, and he knew that once dark fell, he had to move. His lips were dry and cracked, and he ached for water and food, and he didn't know if his arms and legs would work. After dusk, he listened for the voices, but they had moved away from the pit. He watched and listened, and the stars appeared and flickered across an endless sky. And then he moved. He began by wiggling free from the dead that covered his legs and pressed against his head and chest. And as he twisted and turned, he had to bite the collar of his shirt to keep from screaming as a shot of pain raced down his spine. Rats and mice skittered across the dead litter as if aroused by his movement. And with a clenched jaw, he freed himself from the bodies. He was hurt and thankful for the dark, so that he couldn't see what he looked like, because he knew that would make it easier to give up. He crawled up, stiffened bodies and the smell of hell, and eyes frozen open that envied him as he maneuvered his way to the edge of the pit. Again he listened and he heard voices, but they were at a distance, so he lifted his head and looked out across the land. Maybe 100 yards away, men gathered around campfires and milled around tents. There were hundreds of tents and dots of firelight orange spread out across the treeless fields, but they were all away from the pit. And then he heard a weak voice, "Help me." He turned and looked, an arm raised from the corpses, and the voice came again, "Help me." A soldier yelled something at the edge of the German campsite, and he couldn't wait. He wanted to say to the voice, "I can't help you. I want to, but I can't. And I hope that you don't remember that I was here and that you asked me, but I can't. And I pray that you die before they bring the fire."